Welcome to Mathematics class, Chapter 6, Fun with Give and Take, Part 3. It is a story problem. The statement is, there are 13 boys and 14 girls in a class. You have to make a problem from this statement. Problem means you have to make a question. So the question is, whatever Sonu made, how many students are there all together? So now here 36 men and 52 women waiting for their turn to cast vote. Answer, there are 36 men and 52 women standing in a line to cast their votes. How many people all together have come to cast their votes? So the question is, how many people all together have come to cast their votes? Next also, here is also a statement. From that statement, you have to make a problem. So, question statement is, we have our midday meal in 20 minutes and play for 15 minutes. So, how we will make the problem? Answer, the students of a class take 20 minutes to take their midday meal and after that they play for 15 minutes. How much time do they need for both the activities? This is the question. How much time do they need for both the activities? Here also one more statement. The post office is 1 kilometer from Shahid's home and 2 kilometers from his school. So the question, if the post office is located in between school and home, then find the total distance between Shahid's home and his school. So this is the question. What is the question? The total distance between Shahid's home and his, find the total distance between Shahid's home and his school. Another statement here, Bunty has read 27 books and Bubbly has read 34 books. So the question is, who has read more books and by how much? Now here, this is a problem of subtraction. You will do it by forward counting. From 13, that is the smaller number, to 48, that is the greater number, in steps of 10. So here we will start counting from 13 to 23 in steps of 10. In 10 steps, then 23 to 33 in 10 steps, then 33 to 43 in 10 steps, and then 43 to 48 in 5 steps. So how many total steps? 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 5 equal to 35. So 48 minus 13 equal to 35. Clear? Next also 56 minus 37. So here also you will start from 37 and forward count up to 56. So from 37 to 47 in 10 steps, then 47 to 57 in 10 steps, and then back count one step to 56. So 10 plus 10 equal to 20 minus 1 equal to 19. So 56 minus 37 equal to 19. Now next 60 minus 45. Here also you will start from 45 and forward count up to 60. So 45 to 50 in 5 steps, 50 to 60 in 10 steps. So 5 plus 10 equal to 50. So 60 minus 45 equal to 50. Next 60 minus 45 equal to 60 minus 45 equal to 15. Next also 80 minus 59. So here also you will start from count from 59 and forward count up to 80. So from 59 to 60 in one step, then 60 to 70 in 10 step, then 70 to 80 in 10 step. So 1 plus 10 plus 10 equal to 21. So 80 minus 59 equal to 21. Here also some more problems are there, subtraction are there. You will do this. 85 minus 63 equal to 22. 84 minus 69, 50. 60 minus 20, 40. 90 minus 50 equal to 40. These all I have done, I have solved in the next slide. Question number, now next question, that is 85 minus 63. So you will start your forward counting from 63 to 85. So 63 to 70 in 7 steps, then 70 to 80 in 10 steps, 80 to 85 in 5 steps. So 7 plus 10 plus 5 equal to 22. So 85 minus 63 equal to 22. Next 84 minus 69. So from 69 you will start forward counting to 84. So from 69 to 70 in one step, 70 to 80 in 10 step, 80 to 84 in 4 step. So 1 plus 10 plus 4 equal to 15. So 84 minus 69 equal to 15. Next, 60 minus 20. So we will start our forward counting from 20 to 60. So 20 to 30 in 10 step, 30 to 40 in 10 step, 40 to 50 in 10 step, 50 to 60 in 10 step. So 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 equal to 40. So 60 minus 20 equal to 40. Here 90 minus 50. So we will start our count from 50 to 90. So 50 to 60 in 10 steps, 60 to 70 in 10 steps, 70 to 80 in 10 steps, 80 to 90 in 10 steps. So 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 equal to 40. So 90 minus 50 equal to 40. Here is a story, All the King's Horses. Once there was a king who could count only up to 9. Up to what number can you count? The king loved horses. So here what I have told, up to what number can you count? You can count up to 100. So the king loved horses, but he could never count all of them. He kept them in such a way that he needed to count only up to 9 from each side. So here, students, he arranged the horses in such a way, so from all sides it will be 9. 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9, 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9, 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9, then 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9. All side it will be 9. Though, so the king will not know. So that means the king arranged these numbers in such a way that from all side it will be 9. So how many horses in all did the king have? So that is 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9, plus 3, 12, plus 3, 15, plus 3, 18, plus 3, 21, plus 3, 24. So how many horses in all did the king have? Total, that is 24. One day, a visitor with four horses came there. It was getting dark, so he wanted to stay there at night. But the horse keeper was scared. If the king saw these extra horses, he would be very angry. The visitor said, "Don't worry. The king will never know." So he arranged the horses like this. He arranged the horses in such a way from all sides it will be 9. How? 2 plus 5 plus 2, then 2 plus 5 plus 2, 2 plus 5 plus 2, 2 plus 5 plus 2. Okay? So, the king will not know. So, this all side, from all side, it will 9. It will be 9. So, the king will not know. At night, the king came to count horses. Along each side, he counted 9 horses. Ah, that's fine, he said. Then he happily went to sleep. So, how many horses are there now? That is 28. In total, that is 28. In the morning, the clever visitor tried another trick. He took out his own 4 horses. But he also ran away with some of the king's horses. He left the king's horses standing in this way. How? 4 plus 1 plus 4, 9. Again 4 plus 1 plus 4, 9. Again 4 plus 1 plus 4, 9. Again 4 plus 1 plus 4, 9. In all side, it will be 9. So, the silly king did not find any horse missing. So, actually, total horses there 28. You know that. So, how many horses are left now? How many horses are left now? 20. How many of the king's horses were taken away? 4. So, this answer's explanation, this is, the king had 24 horses in all. So, the visitor had 4 horses with him. When he kept his horses with the horses of the king, then there were a total of 28 horses. So, now from 28, the visitor took out his 4 horses and along with some of the king's horses. So, total number of horses left 20. Number of king's horses taken away by the visitor 24 minus 20 equal to 4. So, thus the visitor took 4 horses of the king along with his own 4 horses. Okay? Clear? We are ending chapter 6, part 3 here. Practice all the sums in your notebook. See you in the next class.